Hello students, today going to see a small 5-mark question that is called as a different structure of the determination during the different effect at the chemical bond. So number one is the inductive effect, number two is the bond length, number three is the bond energy, and number four is the bond angle. So first one is, in our syllabus it's not convenient about inductive effect, bond energy. So we have to concentrate only on the bond length and bond angle. So in previous section we have to see the bond angle and torsion angle. So similarly, this is a one effect that is called the inductive effect. The inductive effect refers to the polarity produced in a molecule as a result of higher electronegativity of one atom compared to the other. Simply, we can say that inductive effect is defined as a permanent displacement of shared electron pair in carbon chain towards more electronegativity atom or group. So types of inductive effect, having a negative and positive inductive effect. Here we will describe about this clarification. Negative inductive effect is the electron withdrawing nature of the group or atoms is called negative inductive effect. It is indicated by minus I. Following are the examples of groups in the decreasing order of their minus negative effect. So similarly, electronegativity and inductive effect, two principal electron withdrawing the substituent, can increase acidity of nearby atom, which increases with electronegativity and decreases with increasing of the atom, increasing distance of the atom. This figure shows the more acidic of the different carbon atom in which the electron withdrawing substituent can increase the acidity of nearby atom. So similarly, the positive inductive effect, it refers to the electron increasing nature of the groups of atoms, is denoted by plus I. The following are the examples of groups in the decreasing order of their effect. So this is a effect in which the positive charge should be a change. The changes should be shown in the figure. We can see that this is a finally the R group should be a changes in the methane. So similarly, this is a graphical chart of the strong base in different positive and negative group. So similarly, this is a plus and a positive and inductive positive and a negative effect group should be a changes from the electron denoting CH3, CH2R, CH R2CHR3. This is the negative electron withdrawing from the fluorine, carbon, bromine, iodine, then ammonia. Like that, the different angle should be a changes from the different effect. So similarly, this is the application of inductive effect. So from that, we have to move the our syllabus topic, that is our convenient topic, the bond length. This bond length should be a teacher already seen in the previous classes. So what is mean by bond length? Distance between center of bonded ions are called bond length or bond distance. Or when two atoms are bonded by a covalent bond, the distance between the centers of the two nuclei is called bond length. Bond length is related to bond order. When more electron participation bond formation, the bond will get shorter. Bond length are measured by the X-ray crystallography and by microwave spectroscopy. The unit of the bond length is Armstrong. For most bonds, the values are 1 Armstrong to 2 Armstrong. Some typically bond lengths are given below. So this is the bond length measurement for sodium and chlorate atom. The figure 1 shows that bond should be a close identical between proton to proton, that is called as sodium to sodium. So similarly, the second diagram shows that chlorine to chlorine, it should be attracted from the one normal bond distance. So similarly, the different second atom, that is called, second is called as a sodium chloride, how it should be attracted in a bond between two identical atoms. Half the bond distance is equal to the metallic radius, covalent radius and ionic radius respectively. This is the bond should be a changes from the van der Waals radius is defined as half of the internuclear separation of two non-bonded atoms of the same element on their closest possible approaches. Similarly, This is a bond energy. What is the bond energy or bond strength? It defined as amount of energy required to break a bond in a molecule. So similarly, the bond energies depends upon the type of bond as well as the structural environment in which the bond is situated. They are determined by quantity measurement of heats of chemical reaction and by the spectroscopic method. The unit of the bond energy is chlorine call per molecule. This is a table shows the how bond order, average bond in terms of length, bond average bond in terms of energy should be a change from the C single bond, C double bond, C triple bond. Like the bond order should be a change from the different average length and a different energy. So from that we can move to the some bond energy list in which the molecule should be a changes from single bond to double bond, double bond to triple bond. So from that we shall move to the another topic that is called as a bond angle. A bond angle is the angle formed between three atoms across at least two bonds, or a bond is a bond angle is the angle between two bonds originating from the same atom in a covalent bond. The figure shows the hydrogen to hydrogen should be in between the oxygen, the value should be attracted from the bond angle. So similarly, in the triple bond, in the CH4 molecule, in methane molecule, it should be a change from the hydrogen to hydrogen. It should be a convenient, whatever it may be, the atom should be a three atoms should be concluded. So this is a different angle from the number of regional spatial arrangement, line dash which notation, electron pair geometry. These are the four notation in which the different bond angle should be calculated. From that, VSPR theory is not necessary for our topic, so we can skip that. From that, we have to conclude the different area of different crystal structure. Now, from that, I have to stop the one kind of angles, torsional angle, bond length, bond angle, inductor effect. These are the basics of the astrocrystallography, in which the structural determination should be a finding out from that small definition. So, thank you.